Hey guys, it's Leonor with LDM Creations, and today I just wanted to do a really quick cake topper for a couple of birthdays we're celebrating in my family here. But I want to show you, I just got this Caterpillar. It's actually spelled Cutterpillar Pro, and I got this at my crafts channel. They just launched, and I got it for, I believe it was $79.99 plus shipping and handling. It came to about $85. And it cuts pretty good. I like the feature that it has, this really cool, let me back down here, LED light on the side, so you can totally tell where you're cutting. And it has a self-sharpening knife, and it's pretty good. At first, I was needed to get used to it. It has this little wiggle thing. Basically, when you use your cutter, make sure that the blade is against the metal portion of the cutting. Otherwise, your cut is not going to be straight. So, in any event, let's begin by using this cutter. I printed on my computer, the sentiments, to put in my banners. So I'm just gonna try to cut them, and then I'm gonna use my punch to punch circles with them. This is just basically so I can do the basic scallop. Let's see here. And I got my two scallops. I have the big scallop and the small scallop. So I'm gonna put, this is 2 1/4, and this is 2. So let me go ahead and use the 2 first to cut these, to punch these. And I printed them twice because, you know what, it just needs a sliver more of cutting here so it can fit in the center. So I'm going to go ahead and slide it here, punch it, and you'll see why I'm doing 2 of each. Okay, and then this one, and then let's see, right here. Okay, so I'm done with this portion, and then I'm gonna cut a mat for these ones here, and I'm gonna use the larger scallop. So let me get my paper. I still haven't decided what background paper I'm gonna use, but I think since I have a bunch of scraps, let me do this, like, it's like a teal color. So let me cut 4 of these. And then I'm gonna go ahead and adhere my happy birthdays to the mat here. I should have cleaned up my glue. Well, let me clean it up. I guess it's not coming up. Okay, so I went ahead and glued them, and I inked the edges with the G-Studio. And this is the, what's the color in this one? I don't know, it's kind of like a raspberry color. And to make the banners, I'm using the Birthday Bash, Cricut cartridge. And Birthday Bash, and the banner is on page 59, right here. This one right here. So I cut them at 3 inches, and I cut 4 of them. Because what I'm gonna do is I'm using these bamboo skewers. Let me back this up here for a minute so you can see. These are the ones that you buy to basically grill, and they have a point. And since I'm not a baker, I didn't bake the cake. I went ahead and bought the pre-made one. But since it's pretty simple, I cut these banners again at 3 inches. So I'm gonna put the skirt in, kind of like a big toothpick, and put it in here. So let me go ahead and glue. I cut 4 banners, so I cut, you know, the front and the back, so you don't see the ugly skirt in there, you know. So I'm gonna go ahead and glue the skirt in the middle using my quick dry scotch adhesive. This is really good, and I like it because it dries real fast. So let me do that, and let me be right back with you guys. And let me just show you really quickly. You know, I just put the glue in the edges here to glue it together, and I put one here to glue the bamboo stick. Some here, then I lay my thing here, and then I put the bamboo skewer in there. Hold it for a second, and then put the glue on the top so it catches the second portion of the banner, and then line it up as best as you can. And let's just line it up here. Okay, let's see. Okay, so let's see, we got the points here and the holes match up. Okay, and the skewer is there. I love this glue because it dries really fast, and you can glue all kinds of materials with it. So let me wait a couple of minutes so the glue gets set really well to decorate my little banners. Okay, so now my glue, it's a little dry now, so let me show you. I'm gonna go ahead and glue the each congratulations, and I'm gonna use the 3D dots, the 1/8, because they're a little thicker. I like them to be a little thicker. So let me go ahead and get a couple of the big ones here. Let's see. Okay, and do the other side. Let's see. Glue it here, and now this is probably gonna look weird to you guys, but actually this is the right way. It's gonna come the right way here. So there it is. Okay, so now this is done. I'm not gonna do the other one to make the video shorter, but the next step is, I didn't like the way, you know, the holes look, so I'm gonna get a piece of scrap, you know, that I have from the summer collection. And I have my Martha Stewart punch, and this is the 3D flowers, so I'm gonna go ahead and punch some of these here. Let's see. I'm gonna punch maybe like, I'm gonna punch 4 of them. And they're all over the place, so I have to gather them up. And you see, that's how you use your scraps. Okay, so let me go ahead and glue these ones. And they're a little glittery, so it's gonna look really cutesy and girly, because these are for 2 women. So let's put these in here so they cover the holes. Makes it look really pretty and feminine, right? And what is a project with that stickle? So let's go ahead and do some stickles. I love stickles. So let me put a dot in every one point of the scallops. I just love the way it looks. Little bling in there. You know what? And I think I'm gonna do the inside too. Maybe a little over the top, but it's gonna look cute on top of the cake. Okay, so then I'm gonna wait until that dries off. And this is really simple project, you know, for cake topper. It's for an adult, you know, you can do a variation with, you know, the kids. You can pick a kids theme decoration, but since they're adults, I just wanted to keep it a little more adult, but still feminine. So here it is, guys. Let me make a little closer here. And until the next time, thanks for watching. And if you want to know what kind of materials I use, is basically DCW paper. I love DCW paper. It's the best. And it gave success punches along with stickles and a bamboo skewer that you can find in your kitchen when you're grilling whatever is left over from the summer. Okay, thanks guys, and until the next time, thanks for watching and happy crafting.